Okay, in this video I want to briefly talk about the multiplicative inverse of complex numbers, because this will have some relevance when we come to do division of two or more complex numbers. So the multiplicative inverse is defined as when a complex number is multiplied by its inverse, the result is equal to 1, a real number. And so for any given complex number z equals a plus bi, it has been found that the multiplicative inverse of that complex number is equal to a divided by a squared plus b squared minus b divided by a squared plus b squared I. So the real component is equal to a on a squared plus b squared, and the imaginary component is equal to negative b on a squared plus b squared. Or if we want to factor out the a squared plus b squared, we can write 1 on a squared plus b squared outside of a minus b I. So the question is, how do we get to this result for the inverse? What's the proof? Well, let z equals any complex number, so a plus bi, and let the inverse of z is equal to another complex number, c plus di, and let's multiply these two complex numbers together, so we'll get a plus bi times c plus di, and if we distribute this out we get a c plus a times di plus bi times c plus bi times di. And then if I simplify this, I get ac plus ad plus bc times I, and then plus bd times I squared. And now I squared is equal to negative 1, so this further simplifies to ac minus bd as the real component, and then plus AD plus BC I as the imaginary component. And this result we know is equal to 1. So what this means is we can set up a system of two equations where AC minus BD, which is the real component, is equal to 1, and the imaginary component AD plus BC is equal to 0. And we want to solve this system of simultaneous equations to get B, to get C and D in terms of A and B. So the first thing I can do is to multiply 1 by negative B, and this will result in minus ABC plus b squared d is equal to negative b. And then if I multiply equation 2 by a, I will get a squared d plus abc is equal to 0. And then if I add these two together, I can eliminate these ABCs because negative ABC plus ABC is equal to 0. So I end up with A squared D plus B squared D is equal to negative B. And if I factor out a D, I get A squared plus B squared outside of D is equal to negative B. And then of course D is equal to negative B divided by A squared plus b squared. So this is one result that I'm after. Now for c. If I multiply 1 by a, I get a squared c minus abd is equal to a, And then if I multiply 2 by b, I get abd plus b squared c is equal to 0. So then similarly, adding the abds will cancel out, and I'm left with a squared c plus b squared c is equal to a. And that, of course, translates to c is equal to a divided by a squared plus b squared. And this is the second result that I'm looking for. So this confirms that the multiplicative inverse of a complex number does exist, and it's equal to a divided by a squared plus b squared for the real number, and negative b divided by a squared plus b squared for the imaginary component. If you have found this video useful, please give me a like and subscribe to my channel, and we shall be further exploring complex numbers in our next series of videos. So stay tuned, best of luck with your math studies, and I'll see you next time.